After a fast-track digital upgradation of the Indian education system during the COVID-19 pandemic, the Human Resources and Development Minister Ramesh Pokhriyal released a report on the country's digital education 2020. The report elaborates on the innovative methods adopted by the Ministry of HRD, Education Departments of States and Union Territories for ensuring accessible and inclusive education to children at home and reducing any learning gaps. Given the largest number of smartphone users and deep penetration of the internet in the far-flung areas of the country, it's so much easier and effective to impart education in remote areas. Quality digital education has now become one of the top priorities in the present context of globalization. Ministry also said that the government is trying to reach the students across platforms. It has initiated many projects to assist teachers, scholars and students in their pursuit of learning like the Diksha platform, Swayam Prabha TV channel, on-air Shiksha Vani, e-Parthshala and telecast through TV channels. Besides, the central initiatives, state and union territories governments have also managed the critical task of providing digital education at the doorstep of the students. Some of them were also using various popular social media platforms to connect to the student. Despite the focus on digital to ensure inclusive learning in remote areas, states and union territories have also distributed textbooks at children's doorsteps. Digital education initiatives are also enabling enhanced support for students preparing for competitive exams in the country.
Central Board of Secondary Education and Intel India have set a Guinness World Record by delivering artificial intelligence lessons to the maximum number of students in one day. India's Central Board of Secondary Education, CBSE and Intel India have set a Guinness World Record on 14th October for maximum users to take an online artificial intelligence lesson in 24 hours. The record was set after delivering a virtual lesson focused on demystifying the impact of AI and key considerations around its use to 13,000 students from class 8 and above between 13th October and 14th October. The training was part of the ongoing AI for Youth Virtual Symposium organized by Intel and CBSE. The enthusiastic response to the virtual AI lesson from students across the country shows that India's youth is engaged and eager to explore and innovate.
Hello viewers, Business Gali mein aap sabhi ka ek baar fir se swagat hai. दोस्तों, शिक्षा जगत के गलियारों में ये सवाल बार बार उठता है कि बच्चों को शिक्षा कैसे दी जाए. आज हमारे एक्सपर्ट्स यही बता रहे हैं.
The most important part in the Montessori method of education, according to her, a child is educated right from the time the child is in the womb of the mother. So means education starts from the womb of the mother. So it's very important that when the child comes to this world, the child is already seeing a world that has got a lot of things to give back. And now the pre-nursery or the preparatory phase of the child's education starts. And according to her and according to many psychologists, that the highest amount of creativity at age of 8 years. That means up till class 2 or class 3 maximum, the child has the highest form of creativity. So we need to pump in as much of creativity to the child in the form of handwork, learning by doing, so that the motor development starts, hearing starts, observation starts, everything, all the skills of the body starts working. So more than giving them more written work or more than making them do rote learning, it is best to leave them in a very informal way and to learn and to teach them and make them learn from nature and make the way to teach them or to make them learn the way they want to learn, instead of the teacher putting in a kind of a pressure that this is the way we have to do it. So the preparatory class needs to be very, very creative, and very, not only creative, creative is just a word, innovative, newness. Every day the child should feel that something new I'm going to learn. And this is how the teachers need to be very, very abreast with the new patterns of teaching and with the new pedagogies that are there to teach the children. So that's how they have to impart education. They just cannot stick or become very boring teachers. They need to be very, very active teachers. So for me, a teacher is not only a mentor or a facilitator. As they say, for me, a teacher is a coach. They need to guide them. They need to just be with them to take out the best out of them. And I'm sure the children will give out the best if the teachers know how to guide them. In my school and in my ideas, I do not go by any set methodology. I have again and again told my teachers, look at the child, understand the child. What you have seen the child last year is not the same thing what you will see this year. Because every year, they are 21st century children. We are the 20th century people. There's a big gap between us in our learning and in our understanding pattern. So children today are very, very intelligent. And they can pick up things at the spur of the moment. So I make the teachers understand the child. I make the teachers take a lot of training. And sometimes, right now, we are redesigning our own course. We are not going by the course or the curriculum that has been given to us. We are looking at the children and we are trying to find out what would be best for them. So that's how I believe. Yes, teacher training is a very important thing. They need to be trained, but not in the same pattern. Because if every teacher teaches in the same way all over, in the same method of teaching, then we are preparing everybody in the same way. And today, it's a big thing for competition for jobs and all. So how do we enhance the mindset of the children? What is in Delhi, if we do it here, it's not going to be relevant. Because as you see, my school is in a very pastoral background. So I can just take the children out. I can make them learn from nature. I can make them understand, feel, touch the soil, make them grow trees, make them understand what is local economy, because there is a lot of space to do here.
आज बिजनेस गली में बस इतना ही. अगले अंक में आपसे होगी फिर मुलाकात. तब तक के लिए नमस्कार, गुड बाय.
एजुकेशन 4.0 एक ऐसी शिक्षा पद्धति है जो फ्लेक्सिबल करिकुलम, आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस, पर्सनालिटी और इनोवेशन पर आधारित है. एक क्रांति भारतीय शिक्षा जगत में आने वाली है. इसके प्रति लोगों को संबोधित करने के लिए यहाँ एक सेमिनार का आयोजन किया गया. आइए देखते हैं.
यहाँ एडयू 4.0 समिट का आयोजन हुआ है. इस समिट में भारत के कई प्रसिद्ध शिक्षाविद भाग ले रहे हैं. बात हो रही है कि एडयू 4.0 को भारतीय शिक्षा पद्धति का अंग कैसे बनाया जाए. अब सवाल उठता है कि एडयू 4.0 है क्या. शिक्षा जगत के सामने एक चैलेंज है कि अपने आप को एडयू 4.0 के लिए कैसे तैयार कर रहे हैं.
तो इंडस्ट्री 4.0 का फीचर क्या है कि जो अलग अलग मशीन्स है और आदमी और मशीन्स भी है, ये सब लोगों को कनेक्ट करने का जो है वही इंटरनेट ऑफ थिंग्स जो इसको जो हम कहते हैं, तो उसमें उसके ऊपर ज्यादा भर है, यानी एम्फेसिस है. तो इसलिए जब हम इसमें आते हैं कि एजुकेशन में भी, तो जो हमारा इतने दिन कैसे था कि एक करिकुलम था यूनिवर्सिटी का, सारे स्टूडेंट को वही सीखना था, तो वहां से बढ़कर छात्रों को जो इच्छा है उसको पढ़ने की संभावना जब हो जाती है.
एडी 4.0 आने से निश्चय ही भारतीय शिक्षाविद में एक क्रांति आएगी. कॉर्पोरेट को मनवांछित स्किल्ड लोग मिलेंगे, विद्यार्थी को अपना पोटेंशियल फुली यूटिलाइज करने का मौका मिलेगा और भारत डेवलपमेंट कंट्रीज के लिए एक एजुकेशनल हब के रूप में उभरेगा.
हमने अभी डिप्लोमा इन वोकेशन, बैचलर इन वोकेशन जो शुरू किया है, तो किसी भी वोकेशन में स्टूडेंट जा सकता है. उसके बाद यदि डिग्री में परिवर्तित करके डिग्री में आना है तो दोनों का मूवमेंट है. डिग्री से वोकेशन में किसी को जाना है तो जाने की संभावना है, वोकेशन से डिग्री में आने. और समाज में जब इसको ज्यादा लोगों की मान्यता मिलेगी तो ज्यादा ज्यादा लोग वोकेशन के बारे में, स्किल के बारे में जानकारी लेने शुरू करेंगे और हमारा देश स्किल्ड देश बनेगा. स्किल अलग होना नहीं चाहिए, हर एजुकेशन में स्किल अपने आप ही इंटीग्रेटेड ही होना चाहिए.
हमको जो ये नए रेवोल्यूशंस आए हैं इनके मुताबिक ढलना है और ढालना है, क्लासरूम्स को चेंज करना है। क्लासरूम्स वैसे ही नहीं रहेंगे जो आज से 50 साल पहले थे, 100 साल पहले थे या 200 साल पहले थे। हमने क्लासरूम्स के ओरिएंटेशन को बदलना है, लर्निंग के सिस्टम्स को बदलना है। हमने जो स्टैंडर्डाइज जो मापदंड रखे हैं किसी को इवेल्युएट करने को के या पढ़ाने के लिए, उनको बदलना है। अब आपको पर्सनलाइज लर्निंग पे जाना पड़ेगा।
और इसी के साथ बिजनेस गली में बस इतना ही। मुझे यानी अदिति को दीजिए इजाजत। We'll be right back.